Hello guys, this is Kevin from Crypto MY. In today's episode, it's much more about step by step how to do deposit and withdrawal in Huobi exchange platform. I've been receiving a lot of messages asking me to do a very simple guide on how to withdraw and how to deposit using fiat currencies. So let's get started. Of course, you need to have an account first in the Huobi platform. If you guys haven't registered any account yet, I will put down the link at the description below. You guys can click in directly and do a registration. After you've done the registration, remember to do some verification such as KYC. After you've done the KYC, then you can get started already. Okay, so let's get started. How to purchase cryptos using fiat currencies. Actually, there are two options you can choose, which is one, you buy directly from the exchange platform by using Visas and Mastercard. And the second option is you go to the P2P trading market to buy from a specific seller. From the left side, you can see there is the buy crypto. So what you need to do is you just click on the buy crypto, then it will link you to another page where you can buy or sell cryptos directly from here. Okay, let's say you want to buy $1,000. Okay, so you can input a $1,000, or maybe you want to put in a ringgit Malaysia. Okay, let's say because I'm from Malaysia, right? So I need to put like 4,000. Let's say I want to buy a 4,000 ringgit Malaysia worth of Bitcoin. Now we are receiving in Bitcoin. Okay, let's say I don't want to receive in Bitcoin, I want to receive in a USDT. I can also select USDT. So in the end, what I'll be receiving is I'll be receiving 900 USDT, 919 USDT from this 4,000 ringgit that I have banked in. So I can either do a bank transfer or I can directly do the Visa and the Mastercard. It's very, very straightforward. Okay, let's say if you don't want to buy from here, you want to buy from the P2P market, you can also click at this area, which is the P2P market. It will link to you another web page whereby you can buy directly from the sellers. These are the sellers, and these are the coins that you can purchase directly from the sellers. Okay, let's say I want to buy from the seller. Okay, this seller is offering a 4.35 rate. Okay, these are the rates. Of course, as you go lower, you will see the rates are getting higher. I'll be selecting this 4.35 rate, and each transaction that I can buy from him, minimum amount is from 1,000 ringgit to 50,000 ringgit for each transaction. And this is how many USDT he has right now. So let's say if I want to buy 1,000 ringgit from him, so what I need to do is I need to click this buy USDT, and I need to input 1,000 ringgit, and this is the amount that I will get in the end after the whole process is finished. I will get this rate from him, and from this rate I will get about this amount of USDT. So you need to bank into this CIMB account. Okay, let's say what happens if I click confirm, right? So after you click confirm, you will have a certain time frame for you to bank in, which is they give you a 15 minute time for you to bank into this seller. And this is the seller name, the seller bank account number, and the seller bank name. So what you need to do is go to your bank, do the normal transaction, normal transfer to his bank account. And then after you transfer, remember to screenshot your bank slip just in case anything happens. So once you already screenshot, what you need to do is you just click transfer next. And after you click this transfer next, this seller will get notified from this Huobi platform saying that you already transferred the money to him. And what he need to do is he need to go to his bank account to check his account bank balances, whether he already received your money. So once you already receive the money, from his side, he need to click I have already received. There is a button for him to click. And once he already clicked this button, this USDT 229 will immediately goes into your wallet. It's that simple. Of course, one thing you need to know that if you already transferred, make sure you click transfer next. Do not click cancel. If you click cancel, then everything is gone. Means you cannot get any sense from this person. So make sure you click transfer next, this button, if you already transferred. It's that simple. Of course, right now I didn't transfer anything to him right now, so I just need to click cancel. Okay, let's say if you already have a crypto and you want to transfer it into a fiat currency, there are also two options for you to do. First thing what you can do is you can just click here, buy and sell. You can click over to the sell, and let's say you have USDT in the end in your wallet and you want to convert it back to your fiat currency. What you can do is you can just select Malaysia Ringgit, and depending on how many USDT you have in your wallet, let's say if you have 1000 USDT, and you will get this amount in your bank account in the end. So there are two options for you to choose. First one, of course, as we know, is a bank transfer, and the second one is the Western Union. So once you already if you're okay with this, you can just click on this sell USDT and just follow the steps. After that, you will get money in your bank account. But let's say if you're not unhappy with this rate, you can also sell your cryptos in this P2P market. So what you can do is click a sell here. You can sell directly to this buyer. There are few buyers here. There are many buyers here that are willing to buy your coin, and these are the price that they are willing to buy at. It's a 4.27. Okay, let's say if you want to sell, what you get is this rate, and this is amount that they are willing to buy, the minimum amount. Let's say they are buying at 1,000 to 25,000 per transaction. So let's say if you are happy with this rate, what you need to do is just click this button, sell USDT, and then you just sell the amount that you want. Let's say you have 1,000 USD, this is the amount that he need to bank into you, and once you click confirm, he will get notified within a certain time frame, which is maybe a 15-minute time frame, for him to bank in the money to you. So once he already successfully bank in the money to you, he will click he has already transferred the money, and Huobi will also notify you that he already transferred the money. And what you need to do is go to your bank account, check the account balances, ensure that he already transferred the money to you. And once you already confirm that he already transferred the money to you, what you need to do is just click I have already received, and he will automatically receive the USDT from you. So it's very simple. There are two options. First option is to click quick buy and sell, and the second option is the P2P market. So this is all for today's episode, which is from cryptos to fiat currencies and fiat currencies to crypto. So I think that's all for today's episode. If you like my episode, remember to click like, share and subscribe. I will see you guys in the next episode, and bye bye.